Hello, traders. Gary Wagner here, approximately 1:40 in Honolulu, 6:40 in New York, on Monday, November the 8th, 2021, and this is the Daily Report for Gold and Silver. Continued concerns about rising inflation and a very accommodative central bank, actually global central banks, has moved gold higher yet again today for the third time in a row. We've hit the first level of potential resistance. We'll cover that on our show, but first to the price board. Continued concerns about inflationary pressures, as well as central banks globally maintaining a very accommodative monetary policy, has moved gold and silver to higher pricing today. Gold basis, the most active December contract, is currently up $9.80, about a 0.5% gain at $18.2660, and partially due to dollar weakness, the dollar down roughly 0.33% at 94.025. Silver did exceptionally well today, gaining 1.65% or a total of 40 cents. And the December contract is currently fixed at $24.56. This first chart that we are looking at is a daily candlestick chart of gold futures. Basis, the most active December contract. We have moved up what we consider to be our major level of support from about 1736 to 1771. What is interesting is we are looking at major support at the low of Thursday's candle. What I found most interesting about recent activity in the market is that it did go down following the Federal Reserve statement, the ECB statement, as well as the Bank of England, all stating that they were going to keep interest rates low, at least for the near future. The fact of the matter is it was a delayed reaction, but an extremely strong reaction, as we saw two double-digit days, both Thursday as well as Friday, going up over $20 on each day, and then today, almost a $10 gain. But what I do find also interesting is where the intraday high came in and where gold backed off, because what we can see without any question is that the high matches the 61.8% Fibonacci retracement at $1,827.50. The question is whether or not the market will slightly retrace at this point, give up a little bit of its recent gains, and then move back above this and take out these recent highs that came in at the beginning of September that come in right around $1,840 per ounce. We are looking at a daily chart of the dollar index. We can see that it did sell off significantly today, and we can also see that the recent tops that came in at around 94.57 to 94.60 were slightly taken out on Friday, but the market closed substantially off of those highs, creating a doji. And after the doji came in this long green candle and the red candle today, although the red candle today is not an extremely large candle, it is a variation off of a candlestick pattern that is simply called a three river evening star. That is these three candles here. For it to be a valid signal that the dollar will continue lower, we would want tomorrow's trading session to result in a large candle with a lower low, a lower high, and a lower close than witnessed today. All of the precious metals moved higher today, with platinum gaining 2.33% and is currently fixed at $1,059. Palladium gaining 2.36%, currently fixed at $2,075. And silver, as we said it during the price board, gaining 1.5% or 39 cents and is currently fixed at $24.54. The key, as far as I'm concerned, is there was a key number that we wanted to see silver break above, which it has, and that was 24.27, the 61.8% Fib retracement. We opened at that price point and closed solidly above it. In terms of resistance areas, we're really looking at no real resistance till just shy of $25. That is based upon this top, as well as this top here. And I believe that if we take out $25 per ounce, the next real level of resistance will not come in till approximately $26 per ounce in silver. This has been Gary Wagner wishing you, as always, good trading. We will talk to you tomorrow for the next daily update and review. Bye-bye.